human rights are women's rights, and women's rights are...
Phenomenal woman. That's my mother and all your mother.
Women use to the very best of their ability.
Both men and women should feel free to be strong.
Woman's place is truly wherever she wants it to be.
This is Forgotten Voices, a women's history series. Baseball has always been and continues to be a male-dominated sport. But did you know there was a girl who struck out the Sultan of Swat and the Iron Horse back in the 1930s? That girl was Jackie Mitchell. Jackie was born in Tennessee in 1913. As a child, she lived next door to future Baseball Hall of Famer Dazzy Vance. He admired the girl's athletic ability and taught her how to throw a sinking curveball. It didn't take long for word of Jackie's talent on the mound to catch the attention of the Chattanooga Lookouts, a minor league team. At 17, she signed with the Lookouts, making her the first woman to earn a professional baseball contract. Her first game was an exhibition game against the New York Yankees in 1931. After the starting pitcher tanked, Jackie was sent to the mound. First up was Babe Ruth, the next was Lou Gehrig. She struck them both out. But after walking the next batter, she was pulled from the game. So did a lanky teenage girl really strike out Ruth and Gehrig? Historians offer conflicting speculation. Some say the game, which was originally scheduled for April 1st, was nothing more than an April Fool's Day prank. Others argue the Yankees manager was too competitive to have his two star players strike out to anyone, much less a girl. Neither Ruth nor Gehrig ever spoke on the issue. When asked about the strikes shortly before her death, Jackie responded, "Hell, better hitters than them couldn't hit me. Why should they have been any different?" A few days after the game, Jackie's contract with the Lookouts was voided. The team stated baseball was too strenuous for females. Although Jackie would go on to spend the next 6 years playing for various amateur teams, she grew disillusioned and retired from the sport. And while we may never know the depth of Jackie's true talent, she undeniably paved the way for the women who would come after her, proving women are not too fragile to play ball. Jackie Mitchell died in 1987 at the age of 73. Forgotten Voices is a celebration of Women's History Month.